Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to math cinema. In this video we are going to explain polar coordinates and how to calculate velocity and acceleration in polar coordinates. So let's start by Cartesian plane and how to change to polar plane. In the Cartesian plane we have x axis, which is a horizontal line, and y axis, which is a vertical line. X and y are perpendicular lines and intersect at one point called origin point. And I stand on the origin point and I want to move to any other point, for example, say point A. So I stand on the origin point and I want to move to point A. Let the origin point is my home and point A is the supermarket. And to go to the supermarket, I will move 5 steps to the right, 5 squares on x axis, or 5 steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 3 steps up, 3 steps on y axis, 3 squares, 1, 2, 3. So I arrived and I reach point A. So any point in the Cartesian plane is determined by the values of x and y. The value of x may be positive or negative, positive for right direction and negative for left direction. Also the value of y may be positive or negative, positive for up and negative for down. Now how to change from the Cartesian plane x and y to the polar plane r and theta. In the polar coordinates we have r and theta instead of x and y. R is the position vector of point A, and you know that the vector is determined by two items, magnitude and direction. So here the magnitude of the position vector is the distance from the origin point to the point A, and the direction is theta. For example, to reach point A you should open an angle 30 degrees and then move 5 centimeter. And all of you know that the position vector can be written as xi plus yj. X and y are the magnitude or the steps you should move. I and j are the directions. So to reach point A you should move x steps on x axis, xi. I is a unit vector, or simply I is one square down the x axis. So you should move xi, I plus I plus I plus I plus I and so on. And also then you should move y steps on y axis, or simply yj. J is a unit vector, or simply one square beside y axis. Every one square beside y axis is called j. So you should move yj, j plus j plus j plus j and so on. So r is the position vector, r equal xi plus yj. Now by using Pythagoras theorem, we have the hypotenuse, which is r. R without dash means the length or the magnitude, can be written as absolute r vector, or r without the vector sign. So r, which is the hypotenuse, equals root side power 2 plus side power 2. So now we have that r, which is the distance, equal root x power 2 plus y power 2. And also we have here a right angle triangle, and we have an angle theta. And all of you know that we have mean trigonometric ratios, which is sine, cosine, tan. And cosine theta represent a ratio which is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. So cosine theta equals x over r. From here we are going to make cross multiplication, then x equal r cosine theta. By similar, we have sine theta equal opposite over hypotenuse. So we have y over r cross multiplication, then we have y equal r sine theta. So now we can replace x and y by r cosine theta and r sine theta. So the vector r equals r cosine theta I plus r sine theta j. But now we have a problem, as I and j should be replaced by another unit vectors depend on r and theta. Now we are going to replace x-axis and y-axis by another two axes, I and double I. I and double I are two new axes perpendicular on each other. I is in the direction of increasing r, and I2 is in the direction of increasing theta. And also we have two unit vectors. Instead of I small and j small, I small for x axis and j small for y axis, we have r, er, and e theta. Er is a unit vector in I1 or a unit vector in increasing r. E theta is a unit vector in I2 or a unit vector in increasing theta. So now we have ER is a unit vector along the axis I capital. But also ER is a position vector in the Cartesian plane as it starts from the origin point. So ER is a position vector. ER equal XI plus YJ. I small, a unit vector along X axis. J small, a unit vector along Y axis, as we said before. And we can replace X and Y by their polar values. X equal absolute ER cosine theta. Y equal absolute ER sine theta. So here the position vector is ER, so its distance or its magnitude is absolute ER. So absolute ER is the distance from the origin point to the point here. And also ER is a unit vector. ER is a position vector and also it is a unit vector. So its distance equals 1 unit along the axis I capital. So now we have ER equals cosine theta I plus sine theta j. So we have R equal R cosine theta I plus R sine theta j. Take R common factor. Then we have R times cosine theta I plus sine theta j. And as we said, the position vector or the unit vector ER equals cosine theta I plus sine theta j. So now we have the position vector R equals R ER. R times the unit vector ER. So this is the polar form. Also, this polar form can be noticed by the first look, as we have a direction ER and a magnitude in this direction. So the position vector R can be written as R ER. And now let's continue to get the value of E theta, because we will need it to calculate the value of velocity and acceleration. Now we have the axis I and an inclination angle theta. And we have a 90 degree between axis I and axis double I. And also here we have x axis and y axis are perpendicular. So also we have a 90 degree between x and y. Let the angle between the axis I and y axis is alpha, and the angle between y axis and double I is beta. So now we have theta plus alpha equal 90 degree. because x and y axes are perpendicular. And also we have alpha plus beta equals 90 degree because the two coordinates I and double I are perpendicular. So we have alpha plus theta equal 90, alpha plus another value beta equal 90. So from these two equations, alpha and beta should be the same. So we have theta equal beta. So now we have an angle theta between the y-axis and the axis double I, and we have e theta is the unit vector in the direction of double I, and also e theta is a position vector. So we have theta, and the inclination angle between double I and x axis is 90 minus theta because x and y are perpendicular. If theta equals 30, then the next angle will be 60, 90 minus theta. So we have e theta is a unit vector, and also it is a position vector. So now we have e theta is a position vector because it starts from the origin point. So we have e theta equals negative xi plus yj. Negative x because we move in the left direction, so the value is negative. And as we said, we can replace x and y by their polar values. So you can replace x using cosine the inclination angle and y using sine the inclination angle. So now we have e theta equals negative as it is, and replace x by absolute value of the position vector, absolute e theta, times cosine the inclination angle 90 minus theta I, plus remove y using absolute value of the position vector e theta times sine the inclination angle, so sine 90 minus theta j. And all of you know that the position vector e theta is also a unit vector in the direction of double I. So the absolute of e theta equals 1. And also all of you know that cosine 90 minus theta equals sine theta, and sine 90 minus theta equals cosine theta. This can be proved using Astic rule. 90 minus theta is in the first quadrant, and cosine should be replaced, so cosine will be sine and sine will be cosine. So cosine 90 minus equals sine theta, and sine 90 minus equals cosine theta. So now we have the position vector or the unit vector e theta equals negative sine theta I plus cosine theta j. Before we start to calculate the velocity and acceleration in polar plane, we should do a summary. In the Cartesian plane, the position vector of point A has two forms. The first form is r vector, which is the position vector. R vector equals xi hat plus yj hat, or r vector equals r cosine theta I hat plus r sine theta j hat. So I and j, because we are in a Cartesian plane, I is a unit vector on x axis and j is a unit vector on y axis. And x and y can be replaced by their polar form to be r cosine and r sine. So to go to the point A from the origin point, you can use x value and y value, or you can use r and theta. So these are two forms of the position vector in the Cartesian plane. And you can change from one form to another. Example number one, if r equals 5, theta equals 30 degrees, then find the value of x and y. And as we said before that x equal r cosine theta, so x equal 5 cosine 30, so x equal 5 root 3 over 2. And also y equal r sine theta, so y equal 5 sine 30, y equal 5 over root 2. So if you have the value of r and theta, you can change to x and y. Example number 2, if you have x equals 3, y equals 4, then find the value of r and theta. And as we said before, r is the hypotenuse, so apply Pythagoras theorem. R equal root x power 2 plus y power 2. R equals root 3 power 2 plus 4 power 2 equals 5. And since x equal r cosine theta, y equal r sine theta, divide both of them, so r will cancel r and x over y equals tan theta. Take tan inverse, so theta equals tan inverse x over y equals tan inverse 3 over 4. So use your calculator and put tan inverse 3 over 4. So what is the angle whose tan is 3 over 4? The angle will be 38.86 degrees. So if you have x and y, you can change to r and theta. And in polar plane, the position vector of point A has one form, which is r. In the polar plane, you have two new axes, i1 and double I, and r equals the distance, which is r, in the direction of i1, so r equal r vector equals r. Er is the unit vector along the new axis I, and e theta is a unit vector along the axis double I. And e theta will help us to get the velocity and acceleration in the polar plane. And also you should remember that er equals cosine theta I plus sine theta j, and e theta equals negative sine theta I plus cosine theta j. So now let's start to calculate the velocity in polar coordinates. We have the position vector r equals r, and the velocity is the derivative of the position vector with respect to time. So vector v equals dr over dt. Applying the rule of differentiation, so v equals derivative of first times second plus first times derivative of the second. So the vector v equals dr over dt times er plus r times derivative of er with respect to t. And dr over dt is denoted by r dot. So the vector v equals r dot er plus r der over dt. And you should note that the point is moving in the polar plane, and the point is determined by r and theta. So r is a function in time t, and also theta is a function in time t. So the derivative of r with respect to time t is accepted and denoted by r dot. But the derivative of the position vector er with respect to time t is complicated, because here you have er is a function in theta, and theta is a function in time t. So here you have a chain, er is a function in theta, theta is a function in t. And to find the derivative of ER with respect to T, you should pass through theta. So you should apply chain rule. So by applying chain rule, you have the derivative of ER with respect to theta, then the derivative of theta with respect to time t, and also the derivative of theta with respect to time is denoted by theta dot. So the vector v equals r dot er plus r theta dot derivative of er with respect to theta. Then we want to calculate the value of dER over d theta. Since ER equals cosine theta I plus sine theta j, then dER over d theta equals negative sine theta, because derivative of cosine is negative sine and derivative of sine is cosine. And as we said before, that E theta is negative sine theta I plus cosine theta j, so the value of the derivative is E theta. So dER over d theta equals E theta. So now we have the value of V, vector V equals R dot ER plus R theta dot E theta, and it can be written like this, R dot comma R theta dot. The first component is in direction of R of ER, and the second component is in direction of E theta. Now we want to calculate the acceleration. So we have the vector V equals R dot comma R theta dot, and the acceleration is the derivative of V with respect to T. So vector A, which is acceleration vector, equals dV over dT. So vector A equals d over dT, R dot ER plus R theta dot E theta. Distribute the derivative among these components. So we have vector A equals d over dT, R dot ER plus d over dt R theta dot E theta. Again, distribute the derivative among the values. So here we have d over dt R dot and ER as it is, plus R dot and derivative ER with respect to t. Derivative of dR dot with respect to t is R double dot. So the first component is R double dot ER plus R dot dER over dT. And the second component is first derivative of second, so R times d over dT theta dot E theta plus derivative of first dR over dT, which is R dot. So derivative of first times the second, so R dot times theta dot E theta. So again we have derivative of two components, which is derivative of first times second plus first times derivative of second. So we have R as it is times derivative of first, which is theta double dot. D theta dot over dt is theta double dot. So we have derivative of first theta double dot times second, which is E theta, plus first as it is, which is theta dot, times derivative of second, which is dE theta over dt. And now we have two derivatives for unit vectors. We have dER over dt and we have dE theta over dt. And as we said before, in the velocity, ER is function in theta and theta is function in t, so you should use chain rule. So we have dER over d theta times d theta over dt. And as we said, in the velocity, dER over d theta is E theta and d theta over dt is theta dot. So we have Here the component will be r dot theta dot times e theta. And now we have the derivative of e theta with respect to time t. And as we said in ER, e theta is function in theta and theta is function in t. So you should use chain rule. So we have dE theta over d theta times d theta over dt. And d theta over dt is theta dot. Theta dot times theta dot will be theta dot squared. So we have theta dot squared times dE theta over d theta. And to calculate the derivative of dE theta with respect to theta, we have proved that e theta equals negative sine theta I plus cosine theta j, and the derivative of dE theta with respect to theta will be negative as it is, and derivative of sine is cosine, so it will be negative cosine theta I. And derivative of cosine is negative sine, so we have negative sine theta j. Take negative as a common factor, and it will be negative cosine theta I plus sine theta j. It will be negative ER. So we have the derivative of dE theta over d theta is negative ER. And now we should collect the like terms for e theta and er. So we have here r double dot er, and we have r times negative theta dot power 2. So we have r double dot minus r theta dot power 2 times er. And we have three components for e theta. We have r dot theta dot, and we have r times theta double dot, and we have r dot times theta dot all times e theta. R dot theta dot plus r dot theta dot will be 2 r dot theta dot. So we have here the two components for er. The components in the direction of the unit vector ER is r double dot minus r theta dot power 2, and the component in the direction of e theta is 2 r dot theta dot plus r theta dot power 2. Now we have finished the velocity in polar coordinates and the acceleration in polar coordinates. And you should note that velocity and acceleration in polar coordinates have many applications. For example, it is used to calculate the equation of motion for simple pendulum, and also used in projectiles. So it is very important to you to know velocity and acceleration in polar coordinates. At the end of my video, don't forget to support my channel, like and subscribe, and see you soon in my next videos, inshallah.